Hey guys, it's your boy Homer Ziggy. I'm back in here with another video, and today we're here with King Von Mind 2 official music video. Now look y'all, it's like this. Alright, I'm gonna be straight up with y'all. Before this recording, Morey dropped his album Street Sermons today, so maybe I'll do a live stream to the album, maybe not, we'll see. But it's like this. As soon as when I saw King Von, as soon as when I saw this drop and it said 2 hours ago and such, I mean, come on. Look, like I said, if it wasn't for Lil Durk, I wouldn't have heard of King Von, straight up. And if it wasn't for King Von, I wouldn't listen to Lil Durk. So I had to pay my respect. I had to get on this. It wouldn't be me if I didn't react to some King Von, because trust me, ever since when I've heard of his albums and such from last year and such, I had to. Hell, even one of my church family members or so put me on to him, straight up. So not only shout out to my church brethren for that, but I gotta shout out to both of these dudes, not only to King Von and to Lil Durk for putting me on to both of y'all. But either way, bro, rest in peace to King Von, bro. Man, I wish that one of these days that it would stick down to just music beef and such. Cause I get that most of the times when it comes to like rap beats and all. Sorry, I had to turn off fire. But when it comes to like rap beats and all, rap beefs and all, 9 times out of 10 it always ends like with gunshots and such. But regardless, we just wish that sometimes it's just stay to music and all, but 9 times out of 10 it won't. But either way, rest in peace to King Von. But hey, this song Mind 2 from his album Welcome to Oba, I like that song, man. It's fire for real. But this is like one of my top, you can say, 4 songs that I like from the album and such. But either way, we better check this music video out. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And without further ado, let's end the video.
Jerry Production.
And it's just so crazy to see that he's actually in the video. But it's like this. It's like this. When the Lil Durk said, like in an interview or so, I could be wrong, correct me if I'm wrong, but he's saying that this before his death and all and such, he was working on this stuff, bro. He was non-stop with his work.
Beat the Mazen when he ain't trying to. Ain't finna beef about no bitch dog, she mine too. Press these niggas about them issues up that iron too. Put all my ops on t-shirts, come through like a dry dude. Took was playing crazy, so he got bad too. Caught it on my brothers, I do mine too. Come through all these snakes, I use a fan too. Back to back them race, we in the line too. Took was playing crazy, so he got bad too. Back to back them race, we in the line too. Why they shoot out with the ops? Niggas that can't make this up. We hop out on niggas bluff, police hop out, they chasing us. Why they chasing us? We gon' hit them up. Y'all ain't get enough. Now go get them up. The block is hot, but we ain't stopping till we catch a body. Yeah, I got ops, gon' be the one to start it, ain't gon' stop it. Y'all got demons in my body, skeletons all in my closet. Had to game bang, ain't had no options till I made it out of my.
And the thing is, when it comes to him, even though that most of the times like songs like these where he's just in a way flexing, but he's still telling some storytelling with it. Like he's still telling stories or so that goes around in his block and such, old block. So hey man, that's why I like King Von, because it's like this. He blew it up from when he did all of his crazy stories and such from part 1 to, well, 2 was more of a remix or so, but regardless, it's still, it's, I know, but part 1, 2, and 3, bro, All of them was cool. All of those three were all fire as hell. Because it had storytelling, had some bars, and it was a fire song straight up.
Until I made it out of my mind, one ain't trying to. Ain't finna beef about no bitch, dog. She mine too. Press these niggas about them issues up that iron too. Put all my ops on t-shirts, come through like a drive-thru.
Put all my ops on their t-shirt, come through like a drive-thru. And the thing is, I saw on Instagram that, you know, if you guys remember that rapper who tried to beef with the baby and such, Cam Cohart and such, apparently he passed away. So, hey, even though some of the times and so he was like be capping and such, but regardless, rest in peace to him, man. But hey, man, Vaughn was just different.
Issues up that end too. Put all my ops on t-shirts, come through like a drive through. Tuke was playing Chris, so he got bad too. Caught it on my brothers, I do mine too. Come through all these snakes, I use a fan too. Back to back them racks, we in the line too. Niggas, bitches, I know it. I keep my distance like COVID. I got the
niggas know. I keep my distance like COVID and such. I told y'all, Vaughn had, it's like this, y'all, Vaughn had bars. Everybody knows Vaughn got bars and all, but it's like this. The fact that he's actually, like, in most rappers who passed away and such, right? 9 times out of 10, when they're doing a song or doing a feature on somebody else's song, sometimes, most of the times, you will hear the feature and all, but when it comes to their part, where they have a verse and all, it won't hit the same and such because they're not there anymore. But even though he's not here anymore, Vaughn, even though the song he's doing right now, you can actually see that he's doing it. Because most of the times, you would think that it won't hit the same. But hey, regardless of that, man, it's just crazy to see that he's actually doing this. It's just crazy to me. I don't know about y'all, but to me, it's just crazy to see that he's actually doing the song and such, like doing the video and all.
Come through all these snakes, I use a fan too. Back to back them race, we in the line too. Niggas, bitches, I know what I do. My distance like
COVID.
I got the world on my shoulders, just wish my family was close. All the secrecy told him, he gave a statement, he wrote it. I give advice and they quoted, I beat that body, I'm goaded. My bag's so big, I can't blow it. I run the city, they know it. I keep a clock, but don't show it. It has so good, you won't know it. I got some beef up in all the nigga and ain't even know it. I hate you rapping that gangsta shit, but now you gotta show me.
For real, most rappers be rapping that gangster-ish and so, but they don't want to prove it. AKA 6ix9ine. But look, y'all, it's a thing about this. When it comes, most people, like for me personally, right? Most people think that this is all entertainment and all. And at a part of it, it is. But y'all need to remember, this ish is real. No cap. Let King Von's such be a murder and such be a lesson. Like, this ain't just no entertainment music beef and all. This stuff is real. Hell, look at the one with Young and Nace and Fulio One. Like, y'all see them, right? The two catch that, even though they catchy songs, but they're mad disrespectful because both of them talking about dead ops and such. Each other's dead. Each rival's dead ops and such. So, hey, at the end of the day, just remember, besides from entertainment wise, this ish is real.
I beat that body, I'm goaded. My bag's so big, I can't blow it. I run the city, they know it. I keep a clock, but don't show it. It has so good, you won't know it. I got some beef up in all the nigga and ain't even know it. I hate you rapping that gangsta shit, but now you gotta show me. Like I'm Kobe, shoot like Ginobili. Better pay me, you owe me. We get caught, you don't know me. I got rich, now I'm phony. I got old blocks tatted on me. Bitch, I die for my homies. I take your life, you don't know me.
Now that part definitely hits different now. He'll die for his homies. Ah, boy, bro. That part, I swear to that part now, that since he's gone now, that part is definitely going to hit way more different now for others. This hit, that hits way more different now. I got old blocks had it on me, bitch. I die for my homies. I take a wife, you don't know. Who was playing creep, so he got bad too. Caught it on my brothers, I do mine too. Come through all these snakes, I use a fan too. Back to back, them racks, we in the line too. Who was playing creep, so he got bad too. Man, shout out Jerry Productions for that, man. Hey man, it's like this, y'all. Rest in peace to King Von, bro. Trust me, his music is definitely not gone. And it's like this, shout out to Lil Durk too, cause anytime when he gets a chance or so on a song, you know, one way or another, whether it's on his song or on other people's songs, he gonna find a way how to pay tribute or so to his, like his, like his brother and such, King Von. You know, one way or another, you don't pay respect and such. And look, for all those people, it's like this, people were saying about how Lil Durk sacrificed King Von. Stop that, because in that song Hellcat, within the first second of the song, he had a t-shirt with Von's name on. He had a t-shirt with Von's picture on it. He ain't trying to be rude or so. He wasn't trying to be disrespectful at all. The man is paying homage. Like, come the hell on. But either way, bro. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. It's been your boy, Humble Ziggy, signing out. Stay positive and keep the vibes up. Lego.